White in Life with Elizabeth, featuring Del Moore. Number one in the life of Elizabeth occurred just before the impending visit of Elizabeth's little niece, Kathy. Well, inasmuch as Kathy was only 4 years old, Elizabeth and Alvin had to do some studying up on the care and treatment of nieces. Elizabeth, how are you tonight? Well, I see you're getting ready for your little niece's visit, but what's Alvin going to do to make her happy? Why don't you call him in and let's find out.
Alvin.
Hi.
Honey, do you think Kathy's going to like this?
Oh, honey, that's real cute. Oh, you're a genius.
I want her to be happy while she's with us. What's that?
Mother Goose nursery rhymes. I thought I'd memorize some of them so I could tell them to Kathy at bedtime.
You're a good man, Alvin.
Oh, it's nothing.
I mean it. You're a good man.
Well, thanks.
Good man.
Something more than but most anybody.
Now, don't try to minimize it. You're a good man.
Well, okay.
A lot of men wouldn't go to all that trouble for a little girl, but you did. You're a good man.
Thanks again.
That's the wrong answer.
What was I supposed to say?
That's the wrong answer, too. Who made the doll dresses?
Well, you did. I just told. Oh, you're a good woman.
Thank you, sweetheart. You say the sweetest
you.
Thing. Why don't you read me some of those? Seriously, it was a nice thought, honey.
Oh, all righty. Now, let's see. What do we? I know that one. Oh, here. Ding dong bell, pussy's in the well. Who put her in? Little Johnny Green.
Nasty little beast. Well, how can you sit there with that self-satisfied look on your face while the kid puts a cat in the well?
I didn't write it.
Well, you're reading it.
Now, don't get excited. There's a moral to the whole thing. Listen to this. What a naughty boy was that to try to drown our pussycat. See?
That's like saying, I'll be vexed if you shoot Grandpa.
Oh, let's skip that, all right?
I'm sorry, honey, but I feel very strongly about things like that.
Well, so do I, honey. I just didn't notice it, that's all. We'll get another one. Let's see. Oh, here, this is the one. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
Ha. Is that all?
Yeah, that's all.
What are they going to do, let him lie there?
It's only a nursery rhyme. Humpty Dumpty was an egg.
And now he's an omelet. I think that's horrible.
Well, we'll just skip that one then. Hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle, and the cow jumped over the moon. Okay so far?
Sure, that's cute.
The little dog laughed to see such sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon.
That's kidnapping.
Maybe they mean the dish eloped with the spoon.
Well, then it's too advanced for Kathy. Honey, what else do you answer?
Honey, I don't think it's too advanced. It's about a dish and a spoon.
Kathy is 4 years old, and you want to teach her about spooning? You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Well, I've got news for you. I'm not ashamed of myself. And how do you like them onions?
Well, if you're going to talk like a child, the least you could do is be grammatical.
How do you like them onions?
I'll pick out my own stupid nursery rhymes in the other room.
You stay right here. I'm not going to have you warping that child's mind without my help.
No, ma'am.
If there's any warping of minds to be done, we'll do it together.
Okay.
Now, see if you can find one decent rhyme in that vulgar book.
You're going to stand up while I read this?
Yes.
Good, then I'll sit down.
Coward.
Jack Sprat could eat no fat, and his wife could eat no lean.
You keep Mom out of this.
I didn't say one word about your mother.
I know what you're thinking.
So between them both, you see, they licked the platter clean.
And I suppose you think that's table manners.
I knew
that. It teaches the kid to eat all of her food. It licked the stupid platter clean.
Like a couple of pigs.
Where did I say anything about a couple of pigs? Go ahead, show me.
We're screaming at each other like a couple of fishmongers. I wish I were dead.
So do I.
Then I don't.
I purposely left out the part about Little Miss Muffet because you don't like spiders.
Thanks a lot. Don't do me any favors.
I won't. See if this will please your majesty. Little Jack Horner sat in the corner eating his Christmas pie. His Christmas pie. Make something out of that.
Go on, read the rest of it. That's the part I can't stand.
He stuck in his thumb and he pulled out a plum and he said, "What a good boy am I." What's wrong with that?
His manners are worse than Jack Sprat's.
Jack Sprat's manners. He licked the stupid platter clean, didn't he?
I'd hate to see what he'd do with a bowl of soup.
Elizabeth, now listen, you've got to get this in your mind.
Go ahead. Be friends with a bunch of pigs. See if I care.
Pigs? I suppose Humpty Dumpty was a pig. He's an egg.
Well, what about the king's men?
Don't you tell me. If Jack Sprat wants to eat some fat, and if Johnny Green wants to push that cat in the well, he can...
Look at the mess they made.
And I don't think because it's a matter of...
Somebody said...
Listen, I'm talking about...
Aren't we a couple of dopes?
Oh, what should we do with this? Throw it away?
No, it never hurt us when we were kids. But I think you better leave me at this point.
Why?
I'm not fit to live with.
All right. I shall leave you at this point.
Why?
Because you're not fit to live with. Good night, sweetie.
Good night.
Elizabeth, aren't you ashamed? Incident number two in the life of Elizabeth occurred way back in their newlywed days. If I recall correctly, Elizabeth and Alvin had been married about, 6 months when their first real tragedy occurred. Alvin had to leave his little nest because of a business trip. And Elizabeth took it with all the courage of a complete coward. Come on, Elizabeth, things as bad as all that, even to a newlywed like you. Forever.
I'll be brave. I packed your suitcase for you.
Oh, honey, you're all right, Keith.
I won't cry anymore. I hope I packed the right things.
Oh, just beautiful. Just beautiful. Only the ties go up here, honey, like this, you see. They go up there.
You don't like the way I packed your suitcase?
Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do, honey. Look, I've seen a lot of suitcases packed in my time, but I've never seen a job like this before. Fine.
You really like it?
Of course I do.
Look under the handkerchiefs.
Handkerchiefs? Oh, here they are.
Oh, Lamsey, your picture.
I just didn't want you to forget me.
As if I could ever forget my Lamsey.
Anyway, it's not as though I'm going to be gone for such a long time.
Yes, it is. You're leaving tonight. That's one day gone already. What? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
14?
Oh, Alvin, you'll be gone 14 hours.
Oh, this...
We're just not going to be silly, that's all.
That's right.
After all, a lot of men go on business trips and their wives don't act silly like this, do they?
Of course they don't.
You think I'm being silly?
Oh, honey, no, I didn't mean it that way. What I said was that you just won't pay any attention to what I said, but whatever it was that I said, I didn't mean it. Honest, I crossed my heart. I didn't mean that.
You sure you don't think I'm silly?
Oh, of course not, honey.
Raise your right hand and take one short hop.
See, that proves it.
Oh, well.
Oh, oh, sweetheart.
I hope I packed the right things. How's the weather in Ventura?
The same as here. After all, it's only 47 miles away.
Maybe you won't need these then, huh?
Well, no, I don't think so, dearest. I was saving those for our first blizzard.
Maybe I could make them into a stole or something.
I need all of these shirts. There's a dozen here. Must be.
Look what's under them.
Another picture. Oh, sweetheart.
Honey, I just didn't want you to forget me.
Oh, honey, as if I could forget you. Oh. Well, I'll only be gone for one date. I don't forget that.
All right. Calvin, I'll write. I'll write you every hour on the hour. I'll write about all the little things that happen. Like how much the oak tree has grown and stuff like that.
Ramsey, look, if I'm only going to be gone one day and you write every hour on the hour, won't the letters get there after I've left? You see,
you don't want me to write to
them. Oh, honey, yes, I do. Of course I do. Right, surely I do.
You don't care about the trees.
Oh, honey, I love the trees. I love every one of the trees.
You love the trees better than you love me?
Right, yes, write every 10 minutes. Tell me about the trees and the weeds and the bushes and the birds and the bees and you just write.
Are you sure my letters won't be a nuisance?
Of course they won't.
Raise your right hand and take one short hop.
See?
Oh, Albert.
Oh, honey. Just give me some courage.
Like you say, Ventura isn't so very far away.
Yes, it isn't, honey. Now, look, let's do this. Come on, smile for Alvin. No, 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 no. A bigger smile. Broader smile. Huh? Okay. Now laugh. Come on, laugh. Oh, honey, no. A good laugh. Like old times. More. Come on. There. That smile, girl. Remember, Ramsey, I'll be back. Okay.
Have you got enough socks?
I think 12 pair ought to be.
Look what's under your coat.
A coat? Oh, over here in the coat. Oh, honey, another picture.
You won't forget me, will you, darling?
Oh, honey.
I worry so about those wild women up there.
In Ventura?
That's why I keep putting little things in your suitcase.
Honey, you know you can trust me.
What's that?
What's this?
My wedding veil.
Why didn't you put in the marriage license?
Look under the next picture.
It's time, honey. I've got to get out of here. Come on, help me pack. 8 shirts, 9 shirts, 3 pictures.
Wait a minute.
23 handkerchiefs. Your socks. You're going to make a stole out of that. Honey, what's that?
My perfume.
Oh, not so much, honey. Take it easy.
You said you liked it.
Oh, honey, I do. I just didn't want it to shrink the... Well, throw it on.
No. It might be a little difficult to explain to the bellboy.
Oh, that's all right. Don't worry about it at all. Did you put my razor in?
No.
Why not?
Well, it was either that or the pictures.
The pictures. Oh, well. Elizabeth, this is it.
Oh, no.
Elizabeth, you promised me you'd be brave. Look, head up, chin up. Chin high. Raise your right hand. Raise your right hand. Come on, take the hop. Hopsie. Come on. There. Sit down. Put any weight on it. I'll call the doctor for you.
Oh, no. No, you go ahead. You'll miss your train.
Well, are you sure you'll be all right, honey?
Oh, yeah, don't worry.
Well, if you're
don't
sure...
Don't worry about me.
It's all right with you, then. You're okay.
Is the bone sticking out on that side?
Oh, I can't leave you like this. Elizabeth, why don't you come with me? Huh?
Well?
Swell, that's good. Elizabeth, how about your ankle?
Oh, my bones knit so quickly.
Are you already packed?
I've been packed for a week. Come on, hurry up, sir.
Oh, well.
Incident number 3 in the life of Elizabeth occurred up at Lake Allergy in the Los Sierras. She and Alvin had been invited to spend a weekend with their friend Moosey Moosefield on one condition. And Mr. Moosefield made this point very clear. They were not to expect any of the creature comforts of the city. They had to be prepared to rough it.
Look, honey, the moon's coming up. You can see the motorboats down on the lake and everything.
Yeah, it's quite a view you've got here, Moosey.
Boy,
Why? If this is roughing it, I'm perfectly happy.
Oh, me too, honey. Ah, boy.
That dinner you cooked in the fireplace was delicious.
Yeah, it sure was, Moosey.
Pipe down, Moosey.
Elizabeth, for goodness sake, what's the matter with you?
That was a joke, honey. I just mean he can talk better if he puts the pipe down. You understood, didn't you, Moosey? See?
Okay. Boy, I can hardly wait to go fishing tomorrow.
Did I ever tell you, Moosey? The last time he went fishing, Alvin brought home 5 beautiful left shoes.
Never tell him what I said when I got home.
Oh, that was funny.
Wasn't that good?
He said the right shoes weren't biting then.
You got the right and the left, and I caught a lot of the... Hey, Moosey. Hey.
Oh, let him alone, Alvin. He just suddenly become the strong, silent type.
So is his pipe.
You know, maybe he's right. We city people talk too much. We never notice how really beautiful nature is.
Yeah.
Look, honey, the stars are all out.
Yeah, millions of them, like tiny diamonds in the sky.
Listen, darling. Woodpeckers.
There. That's better.
What's better?
I got stuck between my teeth.
No wonder you suddenly went so quiet.
It happens all the time. Gotta be careful. It's the only pipe I got.
Yeah, Elizabeth and I were just saying what a...
Lost that tooth when I was out tracking a cougar in the snow. I was riding on Jazbo. That's my horse, Elizabeth. Say, did I ever tell you about the time Jazbo and me was in this race of Honker's Corners?
No, I don't think you did.
I haven't told you about that! Jazbo and me was in this race, see? And we pulled up alongside of Jim Peters. Well, you remember Jim, Alvin. You used to sit in the third row in Mrs. Weevil's biology class.
Well, who knows?
That's right, the fella with the big nose. Oh, speaking of Mrs. Weevil, she had a baby boy the other day.
What's his name, Bull Weevil?
No, his name's Jim. Which reminds me, you remember Jim Callahan? Used to live next door to Mabel Guernsey. They went together for about 3 years, maybe 4. Thanks. Mabel was a nice girl. But why she ever married Joe Cronkite, I'll never know.
Moosey.
Hmm?
That's all I wanted to know. Come here, sweetheart. Oh. Gee, the moon's so bright. You can even see a few of the speedboats on the lake.
Yeah, you can almost hear them from here. Oh, we'd get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and go fishing, just you and I.
Oh. Listen, darling. Listen how still everything is. There go the woodpeckers again.
Yeah.
Of course, Joe Cronkite was all right, but I'll tell you what me always talking why a fella couldn't get a word in edgeway.
Yeah, I understand. Come here, Moosey.
Something wrong?
No, nothing's wrong. Come on, just tell us some more about this wonderful country up here, Moosey.
Well, that's the lake down there. Tomorrow we'll walk across the other side.
Walk across?
Well, don't be so startled, honey. He means there's a bridge.
No, there's no bridge.
Well, then how do we walk across? Oh, Moosey.
That's better. Say, did I ever tell you how I lost that tooth? I was out of tracking a cougar
Moosey,
in the snow.
Moosey, how are we going to walk across the lake?
Well, dried up 3 years ago.
Well, how about those speedboats? You can see them from here.
Those are speedboats.
What are they?
Hot rods. Every year they hold a hot rod races right down there in the dry lake.
Hey, wait a minute. I came up here for fish.
Well, honey, a rock cod's a fish.
He said hot rod.
I know it, but a rock cod is a fish.
Well, there's plenty of trout the other side of that mountain there. Yeah.
Say, did I ever tell you about the time old Joe contacted me when trout fishing? Well,
if we're going to get up early, we better turn in, don't you think? Where do we sleep, Lucy?
Well, Elizabeth, I thought you sleep on the cot. Alvin, sleep on the couch, and I'll get my sleeping bag and sleep on the floor.
Well, think you'll be comfortable there, honey?
Sure, don't worry about me. You check the couch.
Okay.
Let's see.
Yep.
Boy, am I going to sleep tonight.
Me too.
Oh. Alvin, he doesn't look well.
You go to bed, sweetie, please.
You know, Lucy said we were going to rough it. And sometimes I think women can take it better than men can.
What? Stop me that cougar. Say one knock my tooth out. I'm riding on old jazz, Lucy. When...
What is it?
Don't know how it got in. It's out of key.
Is it a cougar, honey?
No. Be careful.
Oh, here. Where is it?
There.
There?
I got him covered, I think.
Well, don't just stand there. It's dangerous.
I think you ought to know that cod ain't bit nobody in years.
Honey, is it a mountain lion, dear?
No.
Must be that big rattler.
No.
Well, what is it?
A spider.
Is she kidding?
No, she's not kidding. When it comes to spiders, she's a real nudnik.
Well, do something. Shoot it a little bit.
How can you shoot it a little bit?
Don't pull the trigger so hard.
There. He's finished.
Now, go on and go to bed.
No, I will not.
Well, why not? Can't hurt you now.
Well, maybe he can, but what about his wife?
His wife?
Well, sure, she'll come looking for him.
Look, I'm not afraid of his wife. I'll take the cot, you take the couch. Good night.
Please. No.
Why not?
She'll come walking right over that couch and she'll probably bring the kids.
Well, what's so terrible about spiders?
Tell him, honey.
They go doing.
They go doing. Like this.
I'll sleep on the cot, Elizabeth, and you take the sleeping bag.
Yeah. But...
No, thanks. How do I know it isn't full of scorpions?
Oh, honey, stop being silly and go to bed, sweetie. Good night.
No, you go to bed. I'll figure out something.
Alan, we can't take all the room and let Elizabeth walk around all night. It ain't polite.
You worry about me. Alvin wants to sleep with the whole spider family walking all over him all night. That's perfectly all right with me. And you're more than welcome to sleep in a whole bag full of scorpions.
Elizabeth, will you stop that talk and go to bed? Lucy. Lucy. There she is, his wife.
Gosh, she's got 11 kids.
Okay, check the sleeping bag.
You fellas worry about me.
Oh, we're not there. Good night. There's five of them in there, at least.
I guess it's kind of silly worrying about spiders and scorpions and things.
Yes, it is, dear.
Those things are poisonous. Why, Elizabeth saved my life.
Oh, don't let her hear that. I'll never hear the end of it. Shh, quiet. Oh,
wait
a minute. Did you get them all?
Yeah. Just... Watch them over there.
You fellas comfortable?
Oh, yes, dear.
Yes, dear. Yes, Elizabeth.
That's nice. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Elizabeth.
Yeah, the scorpion's that low. Hey. Yeah,
that's all right. Yeah.
Why not say goodbye to the people?
Goodbye, everybody.
Your move.
Well, you're
now here to say goodbye to you is the lovely star of our show, Betty White.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. We had fun. I hope you did. There's one thing we want you to remember, too. As Moosey Moosefield was telling us, there's one thing you never want to do, Elizabeth, he said. You never want to lose your sense of humor. Be with us again, will you? Until we see you again, goodbye, everybody.